The John Blair Talks.
Thank you. What good is in you? Thank you. Her name was Fear, and fear begat obedience. But one day she made a real appearance, a harmless hag with a bag on her back. When the children heard, they gathered together, and in a trice were stalking the little weary traveller. 10, 20, 30, 40. Numbers gave them courage. Though had they known it, Nelly was more timid by far than the timidest there. Once or twice, she turned to look at the bravado'd swollen pack. Slowly, the chant began. Nelly Mulcahy, Nelly Mulcahy, wicked old woman, wicked old woman. One child threw a stone, another did likewise. Soon the little monsters were furiously stoning her whose name was Fear. When she fell, bleeding to the ground, whimpering like a beaten pup, even then they didn't give up but petted her like mad. Suddenly they stopped, looked at each other, then at Nelly, lying on the ground, shivering. Slowly they withdrew, one by one. Silence, silence. All the stones were thrown. Between the hedges of their gift, came children shambled home. Alone, she dragged herself up, crying in small, half-uttered moans, limped away across the land, black bag on her back, agony racking her bones. Between her and the children, like hideous forms of fear, the stones.
Thank you. that?
I tell you mine. Albert's coming.
And who's that?
Well, you hardly think it's a new T-shirt. It's Rich's fella. They're written out for the past 6 months and they're as far on as ever. But you know what? There's supposed to be a bit of a development tonight.
Oh, is Albert going to propose?
No, but Rita is.
We're going to see the doctor or what?
I ignore that remark. Don't you know that this is a lease here? And now that Albert's got a new job, this is Rita's big chance.
And what sort of a job has he got?
With telephone air and digging holes for coal. And if Rita and him were to get married, she'll come to the lease here. And me and him will be happy for the rest of our lives.
And that's what would suit me for.
Will you go on and get out? Rita!
Yes, Mammy?
Did you go there, my girl?
Yes, Mammy.
And you could have sent my dreams.
Yes, Mammy.
And Mammy, I know I'm going to go speechless as soon as I set eyes on Albert. Well, watch as me, Derek, and you do it tonight and you don't do it at all. Remember, a leap year comes only 1 in 4. But I could wait 4 more years for Albert. Will you take no chance?
I mean, held her in his arms and he kissed her. Oh, Albert, wasn't that romantic? Thank you. Look at this life, I still don't know where it's going. I don't know much, but I know I love you. That may be all I need to know.
Thank you. for.
You go on, right?
You have
had
a
lot.
Ah,
you're
Elijah was wounded, he said in my door. He fell up in the Indian raid on a Yankee store. Elijah, oh, he's the damn and let it show. God's he can never answer, yes, and no, no, no. Poor old Elijah, he never got a kiss. Poor old Elijah, he don't know what he's missed. Is it any wonder that his face is red? Elijah, that fool who wouldn't be. He always wore his sunbed, his bells down the hall. His mate for good, his bed, most of the days off. Elijah, he's not there as lonely as could be. God says my brother's no man that he treats, he treats. Poor old Elijah, he never got a kiss. Poor old Elijah, he don't know what he's missed. Is it any wonder that his face is red? Elijah, that fool who wouldn't win. In the old day, workers walked in his way. Each in the road so far away, and all glad to stay. Elijah, oh, he stood there and never let it show. God's he never answer, yes, and no, no, no. Poor old Elijah, he never got a hit. Poor old Elijah, he don't know. Is it any wonder that his face is red? Get an eye to that fool over there.
Queen in Yoga will Andy August, what's her name, explaining up. Your tea was poor and debunked. I've done half as bumped as very good. Finish and answer. Touché, curb, cats and dogs. Well, look.
Was at the end in the spring. The small brooks whistled and sweet to sing, changing their notes from tree to tree. And this song they sang was old.
I'm a part. stiff as her jerseys are too tight. We're the fashion conscious girls, and we like to look just right. The man came to our rescue, cause he liked our company. We wear his name. Thank you.
Thank you. Smith. Say hello to all the nice people, Seamus. I must be going deaf or something.
What? Well, you're a microphone.
There you go.
Did you hear what the ass car bird said to Ben Dunn?
No.
That's right.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen. Well, don't encourage him. I'd like to kick off the season by attempting to do the hardest thing a ventriloquist can do.
Oh, what's that? That's what you call yourself.
A ventriloquist, what would you call me?
Sat.
Well, come on, hate yourself. As I said, the hardest thing a ventriloquist can do is to say the phrase, a bottle of beer.
I mentioned that my gift didn't move.
Well, I haven't moved this time, buddy, because now it's your turn. Say, a bottle of beer.
Gotten a Guinness.
Sure, I suppose it all goes down in one way.
Yeah, just like this act. Hey, this is... What do you think of this act? Do you think it's silly?
Well, I do, actually.
Yeah, but you what? Don't have to lie in a box all day. What did the Escort girl say to Ben Dunn?
Already done that.
How did you know that?
You need your man. Anyway, I have my pocket here if you're planning on a pack of cards. I'm going to attempt to do a little trick for friend Seamus. You're going to hold the pack of cards, and Seamus is going to tell you what card I'm holding up. What card I'm holding up, Seamus?
I don't know.
And why not?
You haven't looked at it yet.
I must say, I really loved it. I love being over here in Ireland.
Yeah, where the people are so green and the grass is so beautiful.
How come the mask is always bringing over here?
Because half our population is over here walking on yours.
Thank you.
place in your heart, and I know that it is love. It's placed as much brighter than tomorrow's. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. In this place, you'll find there's no need for sorrow. There are ways to get there. If you care enough for the living, make a little space to make a better place. Heal the world, make it a better place for you and for me and the entire universe. There are people dying. If you care enough for the living, make a better place for you and for me. Yeah. If you want to know why, there's love that cannot lie. Love strong, love each cares for joy, for giving. Didn't try, we shall see. Love is bliss we cannot feel. They will try, stop existing and start living. And it seems that always love's enough for us growing.
Another group, one way or another, there is one thing for certain, were still there, and we will continue to be there with a very good brain. We may not, in the final analysis, ever win outright the All-Ireland John Clare Tops, but when the time comes for John Clare Tops to finish, if it ever does, we will be there. John Clare Tops has done an immense amount of good for Longford Town and for the surrounding district and for anybody who ever cared to enter a group in the Longford Centre. It's a marvellous thing that come the winter time of the year we can involve our young people in youthful activities, i.e. going to rehearsals here, there and every place else and occupying their time and being happy and contented otherwise than going around kicking in doors and breaking windows and everything else like that. Not that I would suggest for one moment that any of the people involved in John Clare Tops would do anything like that. But we have a situation in this country that that type of thing does exist. So the John Clare Tops is a great thing for youngsters, and youngsters should be involved in it, and hopefully in the future they will and will continue to be involved in the John Clare Tops in London. We have only two groups this year. Limerick have none, Cork have none, Thurles have none, Dundalk have none, Hugh Ross have none. There's none in Kerry, there's none in Sligo, there's none in Donegal, there's none in the York. But there are Tops in Longford, and we will have Tops. And I would like to thank everybody, and particularly people like Tony Donlan. Michael Kennedy. Lord and Joe Lennon. All the people involved in the Stone Park group that were here in Longford and we'll be here again. Factory of Chops, they'll be here again, they'll be here next year. And to all the other groups, the Longford Youth and everything, who have competed all down through the years here, we owe them a great debt of gratitude and we thank them very, very much indeed for their participation. Tonight here again, we welcome Niall O'Shane. He's a John Clare. I always get these things wrong. I'm great at them. I'm very good. I always make too fast, and I don't make too many apologies to anybody. He's the organizer of the John Clare Tops in Ireland. There's no doubt about that whatsoever. He's our lifetime. He's a lovely person, very modest and very quiet in the background. He retired from John Clare some time ago. And yet, they couldn't do it without him, he's still here. So I'll give him a very big hand for you. I'm in the humour of praising people tonight, and sitting behind him, beside him there, is John Maloney, the man with the beard. I spoke earlier tonight of Michael Lennon's baptism into organising a group. John Maloney is at this in years, and he takes dog's abuse from everybody, and he's still there, and he's a marvellous person, and he deserves the height of credit, so please warm your people. On behalf of all of us here, everybody involved in the John Clare Tops, we would like to thank you, the people who come to support us. I know that you all and everybody here wishes us well. A lot of you have youngsters and young people involved in it, and hopefully you will continue to have them involved in it, and that we appreciate all the support we get from you, and I'm sure that St. Vincent de Paul will appreciate the money that they will get through the good offices of this committee here, and particularly John Clare. Thank you very much. Before I hand you over to the next speaker, welcome to Longford, Reverend Mr. Jackson, the new Church of Ireland man here. He replaced Archdeacon Bond. I would like you to give him a very good welcome. He's a lovely man. Very approachable, very nice person. And if you meet him on the street, don't forget to say hello to him, and he will talk to you at any time. He's absolutely a beautiful man. Thank you very much. I have a little note here from the Longford Asthma support group. They put a show on here for another fundraising effort last year. They're a newly formed Longford support group. Maybe they might bring in a top job. And they hope to raise £2,000 to £3,000 for asthma. And they would like anybody who would be interested in being involved in the show to go along to the Europa Tavern. That's Eamon Kiernan's on the main street at 8:30 tomorrow night, if you're interested in being involved in the show in July. Thank you very much indeed. And now I would like to introduce you to Niall O'Flynn, National Organiser of John Peel Tops. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I just want to say a few words on behalf of not only the sponsors of the John Peel Tops, but also now my sponsors as well, seeing I'm now working outside the company. I would like to say on behalf of John Peel Tops, who've been associated with the John Peel Tops now for some 28 years, I think it's quite a record for a commercial company in this country. I would like to say thank you very sincerely to the Longford Committee for having kept the competition going here, not just for so long, but so vibrantly. And I think this is one of the best nights I have seen in the Tops in Longford. Talent will always out in the end. I would just like to mention that the national stages of John Peel Tops this year will be held in Thurles over the Easter weekend, the following weekend in Galway, and the first weekend in May in Athlone. And I hope very much that we might see the Longford team involved as we did last year. And I would just like to say, for my own part, I thought it was a really splendid night. I was talking to Michael Toomey in the hotel before we came down, and we have been to only one centre so far this year, but I've also been at all the preliminary rounds in Dublin. And one thing that did sort of strike me so far this year was that we didn't see an awful lot of what I would call inventiveness and originality of our own culture. I think we saw an awful lot of them here tonight, and I think it's great credit due to the group for that, and I'll really continue.
Thank you very much, Niall. And now I'd like to introduce to you our secretary and the one and only John Maloney, who will present the awards for. That's the award other than the one here tonight. All the future awards, etc. But the microphone, we will do the final one. So big hand please for John.
Following last week's show, tonight's performances are not taken into account. The awards will be presented by Mr. Niall O'Flynn, And for each group, could we have some representatives backstage, please? The first award is the Best Producer Award, which goes to Longford Bachelors in Stitch.
Gentlemen, for the man at the moment, the man who has to decide who wins here tonight, could have a big hand, please, for Mr. Michael Toomey. Thank you very much. Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, first of all, I would like to endorse all that has been said by your chairman, by Nigel Flynn, about the tops here in Longford. I too am delighted to see that the tops are very much alive here in Longford. And I'm delighted myself to be here again this night. It reminds me of the Oscars in Hollywood. One small little correction I would like to make to what you said, Mr. Chairman, was that when you were mentioning where there was none, you mentioned Perlis. You must have been talking about the Tipperary Hurlers. Yeah. Or else, I was only dreaming about adjudicating on two very good shows there last Saturday night. Now, unfortunately, the exception rather than the rule to see a genuine Irish traditional item incorporated in a Tops show. The Young Grattans certainly made up for this tonight, because this was a show that was full of traditional music, dance and crack, all presented in a lively and most entertaining fashion with a dash of country and western thrown in. Now, this is a group that has an abundance of individual talent. Singers,
instrumentalists, dancers, reciters, and comedy players. And I sincerely hope that tonight will be the first of many appearances that they will make in the Tops, because with a little more experience in the Tops format and style of show, I feel they'd be capable of giving a very good account of themselves indeed. There was, if anything, an overabundance of traditional items, and so from a Tops point of view, possibly they limited themselves somewhat under the heading of variety. Yet at the same time, I must admit that there was a great variety of talent within the scope of what they did. I would suggest to their choreographer that she might now experiment just a little bit more with choreography and movement and try different groupings and so on the stage to give us a nicer visual effect. But throughout, the whole show was most lively, very colorful, very traditional, very Irish. I congratulate them heartily on a most enjoyable piece of entertainment. Well done. Then we came to the Longford Bachelors and Spinsters. I'm sure there'll be a lot of marriages out of tonight's show. They call their show Draw Your Own Conclusions. And here we had again another bright, lively show. And this time it was divided into four main sections. You have cowboys, Indians, the Unsod, and Around the World. And of course you can see straight away from the headings that the producer, the production team, intended to give us a wide variety as wide a variety of items as possible. It was obvious from the start that this team was pretty well versed in how to present a Tops show. They made an impact vocally and visually right from the very start. And the cowboy and Indian sections superbly presented, excellent costuming, very good lighting, super choreography, most appropriately devised, and again, excellent vocal work by the soloists and chorus. And I must make special mention, by the way, here, of the wonderful accompaniment they received from the orchestra down the pit. But by the same token, I must also mention the accompaniment from the orchestra in the previous show, which was very good to see. Which was worked into the Indian scene, as you remember, was extremely well played. Some very good topical comment in the scripting. It was funny, clever, and original in concept. And then the Al-Saad section, you remember, opened up with a comedy item on Nocht, well presented in a TV set by an Indian, who seemed to have a very good grasp of Trauma Crusade from Irish. And this section kept up the general standard, most effectively presented Croppy Boy and a lovely colourful You Don't Have to Be Irish, which cleverly included some Hong Kong Irishmen. And we also met the Longford Ladies Hockey Team. Now how these talented and well-developed ladies are still spinsters is a mystery to me. Then the final section Around the World gave us a nice variety of cultures from Hawaii to Siam, from Russia to America. And it included a very clever comedy act by a ventriloquist and a dummy that was almost human. And this with a superb script. To me, this was comedy at its best. So, to sum up this show, we had, all in all, extremely good, lively, varied choreography, very well executed by this well-rehearsed cast. Excellent accompaniment from the orchestra and the paid singers, incidentally. We had super colourful costuming that indeed was a credit to the team of designers. The sets throughout were simple but artistically done and effective, with perhaps the very first. Now I would ask the set designer to have another look at his cowboy set, because I feel just little touches could improve it. The lighting was excellent, was colourful, atmospheric, and always complimentary to the costumes. And the show moved with a non-stop pace from item to item that made the hour fly. Obviously, very talented producer and production team here at the helm of a talented, hard-working team of performers. I wonder, can I say, I think I can, without any contradiction, that it's probably the best show I've ever seen. And of course, if I say that it's the best show I've seen in Longford, automatically they are the winners.
Things, and I'm after forgetting them. To me, it's a great honour to receive this tonight because it brings me back, I think it was 6 months ago, when a handful of people gathered together in the room over Andy Byrne's pub. We had neither pen nor penny. And last Wednesday night, when this show went on stage, I started to cry in the wings because I never thought it would happen. Because today we represent a total involvement of 110 people. And I think that is a fair credit to this town. All I can say, once again, is it's great to be in Longford, receiving Longford's best prize. And to the cast, I have to say, salute. A great night's performance. 1 hour of pure live entertainment. You were terrific. I'm very proud of you tonight. All I can say is, once again, congrats and thanks for putting up a great show against us tonight. Just to bring one thing back from the Temperance Hall tonight. Tops is alive and strong, and everybody look out, bachelors and spinsters are on the way. The pony is packed, we're ready. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, and safe home. That's it for this year. Hopefully next year we have more.
Thank you.